All right, so I figured out microphone and some background music. So I'm going to do a little update. I do have Optifine on with a shader pack. So let's see how I look. Don't remember where I left my body. Perfect. Right. The starter before it loads. So chicken thing that I'm not using anymore. I needed a wool a little bit ago. Got this mine entrance from Mythical Sausage. So check him out on YouTube with the Legacy SMP group. It's inspirational, along with B-dubs and Green and everybody else in the Hermitcraft servers. My cow farm, which I think we've seen before. I think I'm hungry. Yes, I'm starving. Alright, now we can run around. So I lit this up a bit more. Got myself some nether rune stuff for potions. This, I think, is going to be entrance to something. And then this goes downstairs to my mine shafts and spider farm, which I should probably go AFK at here soon. I'm running out of string. I lit up my map. As you can see, I've done a few things. Got iron farm over there. Finally finished my library. Let's see, where was. Let's get. There we go. Tone the volume down a little bit. I finally got around to filling up the river nearby. And a few other things. We're gonna go see that to in this. Kind of like a little update. I did build a slime farm. My first one ever. Luckily, I had a slime chunk right next door to my mine shaft. So all I have to do is drop down, and it just works while I'm running around doing whatever I'm doing. I kind of want to put slime on the floor, because it sounds fun. To walk on. Fill it back up. I'm loving jack-o'-lanterns, by the way, as you can see. I have them everywhere. My starter house still being used. Little farm. I have plenty of hay, though. Cows killed some intruders. I have cats everywhere. So first off, we'll take a little look through the library. I finally finished it. I took some pictures before, but nothing from the insides. So I got my bookcases finished. Where's my guys? There they are. Hey, buddy. Bow enchantment, dude. Flame, infinity. Didn't really need the fire protection, but easy. Super cheap, and then I have my weapons guy, tools, looting, mending, and silk touch, and also some name tags at the end. They are both master. I'm gonna try and run them through a zombie again. See if I can get those name tags a little cheaper. Upstairs is like an attic of sorts, just to kind of even out the height. So it didn't look weird on the outside too, so it kind of worked all together. I love these windows to wall connections. Also inspired by Mythical Sausage. I have been watching his hardcore playthroughs and everything lately. Storage for the books from the guys over there with all that light. We'll jump down, get a little hurt. Is the sugarcane farm. A little mine cart down below. Plenty lit up. Clock tower, I haven't finished yet. And we're gonna gonna circle back to the villager breeder that I followed the tutorial from Logical Geek Boy, also in the Legacy SMP server group. He's got tons of farm tutorials and I've loved them so far. I actually let this run for a little while last week and it is just, they're freaking out in here. I don't know what's going on. But I have my levers that opens up my track without it breaking, and I don't have to jump up and down over and over again. I don't remember. Oh, I can comment, put the in the comment in the description on who this was from. I do not remember off the top of my head. It was a couple weeks ago. I got a bunch of other librarians in here that still need to be upgraded a bit, and probably ran through the zombie thing again. Hang in there, guys. My vine farm noobness right there. Been using a lot of vines this week. The iron farm, also from Logical Geek Boy. My chests are full. I had to turn it off. So that's fun. Let's see, we did that. My little hut. I have been playing around with building with the brick. I really wanted to do brick in this world for some reason. Got that iron front running. I got all those anvils up there, part of the roof. Behind the clock tower is the zombie farm. Sorry, absent-minded a little bit here. Still need to finish and upgrade that. It's just the skeleton, also from a short tutorial, just to get a body and height and the clock face. I really like it. I can't wait to get some end rods to have better hands on the clock though. It doesn't matter who I got this from, everybody does the same thing. I saw it first on Waddle's channel on YouTube. It's getting pretty full as well. Skeleton and farm tube, it was actually pretty close to the surface, so the top tunnel for them to drop down into actually comes above ground, which is kind of cool. I also have a tree farm down there, which I think was all race works, I think so. It works with jungle, spruce, birch, and oak. I do end up with a bit of stripped, but that's okay. It's only one per tree, my dogs. So this will actually repair my axe while I'm using it, which is perfect. And I have easy access to bone meal. I built a bridge the other day. I got super inspired and off I went. I also increased the level of the river, which made it wider as well. Still need to finish this end, but I wanted to finish this side more into town and my base. But I played around with the roof for a hot minute though. It was getting a little annoying where it raises up one more level, but I figured it out. And then see, squid have been spawning more often as well on top of the insane amount that spawned prior. I'll jump up here real quick and we can see head on a bit what I've done. So it was behind there, the portal is taller. I may have brought the I may have brought the basalt down a little too low, so it kind of covers up any most of the effect of the lava in the background. The purple kind of kills the effect. which is a little annoying. I am still in the process of changing some of this stone over to different blocks for texture and changing that dirt into blocks. I did cut this out a bit and added the sand. I do want to put more gravel down there, but I am out currently, so I have to go down and dig up some more, which is annoying. But I do believe there's some big pockets down below. My squid. I feel like most of this should be gravel, at least on the mountain side of the river, because of this weird mountain. That's going to be some statue sculpture at some point. But I did add it. May have too much vines. Probably put some string under some of it so it stops growing. I wasn't too sure about the birch, but it's doing all right. I didn't want to keep just flat grass because I wanted to be able to step up quickly instead of jumping. I do have some stripped birch mixed in with the planks. Mixed up these. I don't know if I'm going to switch all this into more like nether is coming out of the portal. That's what I have in mind, but I haven't figured out how I'm going to do it yet. But there is nether brick and everything down below. Gray glass blocks. I built a little pig farm, piglin farm, zombie piglin farm for gold in there. And it kind of doubles as a enderman farm. Ooh, do I want to go in here? Yeah, I'll do it. I have my gold helmet on. Let's do this. Oh, snaps. At some point, once I finish outside in the overworld, I'm going to come back in here and build a hub on the other end of that. There was a tunnel on the other that my sister built, and her base is at the other end. Let's try not to look at any Endermen, because we do have the Warp Forest right next to us. I dug out a lot of this so more piglin can grow. Oh, he's got his ambulance toy. No mind. I want to dig out some more of that. We do have a little bit of a jump. I do have some resource packs on here. Only on a few doors. But
love getting
I come down here.
Lower than low on food that's fresher
it's,
than fresh. Then shop at Kroger. We
that's pretty
more.
Good. Turn that off. I do have some gas because they are growing in here. I've gotten a couple heads. One of them is on my sister's head wall. She's crazy. But this is just random stuff that Endermen have brought over. I need to carry these all over, get the cleric running. Oh, I guess I left some nuggets in here. he's watching Rabid Rabbits on Hulu. If anybody knows, has remembered the old game, Raymond versus a Rabid Rabbits, or whatever it's called. Furnace is in here for gold swords. This grindstone is in here for gold swords as well for when they're enchanted. That way I get as much gold as possible. I do have an anvil in here. I don't remember why. I think it was when I was enchanting stuff again because I died. I was digging out over here and got blasted off by a ghast. So that was fun. We do. Oof, don't look at me. We do have a fortress down there, and my sister and I were trying to get heads. Oof, he is loud. We went down for some wither heads so we can try and get another star from a wither, but it failed epically. And we died so many times because of a zombie piglin got in the line of fire. Friendly fire always sucks. Back this way is my sister's. I'm not gonna record hers because despite it being pretty interesting, That's not nice. I don't want to invade her privacy. This is for my stuff. But let's go. Well, let's get him out of our portal real quick. Come this way, buddy. There we go. Everybody this way. I did get a magma slime head at some point. I do not know what happened to it. Put it in that box and it disappeared. Woo. That was close. Alright, but yeah, there's all that. That's super fun. Probably take the basalt back up. Fill this whole area with basalt blackstone, since that is a basalt biome that we spawned into. But that's all I've been really up to. I don't have to run over there for slimes anymore, which is fantastic. It took too long, but it's nighttime again, so I'm gonna take that as a hint as this is long enough. I'm gonna hop off here for the night. And go to bed. Do some reading. Get some shut eye. Good night, Moon. Alright. Goodbye, everybody. Thanks for watching. And sorry about my voice. I cannot help that whatsoever.